Today on BRStv, we have the top 5 ways to extend the life of your DI resin. Hi, I'm Nick, host of BRStv, where each week we go over a new topic related to reefing. This week, we're going to give our top 5 tips on reducing DI resin consumption. DI resin often has the highest ongoing cost of all the filters, so it is wise to consider ways to reduce this expense, starting with packing the resin correctly. The mixed bed deionization resin is a mix of positively and negatively charged beads. They need to be packed well, or the two types of beads will separate in the cartridge, and the cartridge will be depleted prematurely. The easiest way to know if you packaged it tight enough is to look at the bottom of the cartridge. If there's a big open space filled with water and no resin, you know it wasn't packed tight enough. There are a lot of ways to pack resin, but one of the most common methods is to fill the cartridge a quarter of the way and tap it on a table 20 or so times to settle the beads. Fill another quarter of the way and repeat until it is full. Once it is full, use your finger to scoop out a small amount around the edge. This will help keep the resin out of the threads when you replace the cap. Next, insert the foam ring and screw the cap on as tight as it will go. The number 4 cause of increased DI resin consumption is TDS creep, which refers to the increased TDS of the initial water flow when the system is turned on. When the RO membrane shuts down, there is high TDS water on one side of the membrane and very low TDS on the other. Once the system is turned off, the water on each side wants to find an equilibrium, which causes the TDS to rise in the product water side. Net effect is the first minute or so of the water produced by the system having a higher TDS, which can deplete your resin more quickly. There are a variety of factors that will impact how big of a deal this is for you. Many people don't have to be too concerned because the initial burst of TDS is as low as 10, but for others it can be 100 or higher, which will have a fairly big impact. The easiest way to deal with this is to simply not use the first bit of water that comes out of the system. However, most of us have the tubes hooked up to storage tanks, so disconnecting it can be a pain. We find it is easier to add a 3-way valve, which allows you to direct the initial surge down the drain and switch it back just as easily. Third way to extend your DI cartridge's life is to maintain your membrane properly. A well-performing membrane operating in ideal conditions will remove as high as 98% of the TDS, so the DI has very little to remove. Generally speaking, if you have 1 TDS going into your resin and your friend has 12 TDS feeding their resin, yours can literally last 12 times as long. This means you may only need to change yours once every 6 to 12 months, and they might have to do it as often as every 2 to 4 weeks. Now, there are more factors than that, such as variances in CO2, but for the most part, the statement is true. So you can see why it is important to maintain your membrane performance. Best way to do that is use a high-quality membrane with a high rejection rate, like the Dow FilmTech 75 gallon per day, and flush the deposits off frequently using a flush kit. The biggest factor with membrane performance is feed pressure, so make sure you're feeding the membrane at least 50 psi. If not, the cost of a booster pump might be cheaper than your yearly DI resin bill. One of the biggest causes of pressure drop and reduced membrane performance is a clogged sediment filter, so make sure to keep an eye on that filter. They are super cheap, and it is way more cost-effective to maintain the sediment filter than it is to keep burning through DI resin. The number 2 cause of increased DI resin consumption is improper storage. This is both at your home as well as where it was purchased. Resin is depleted when it comes into contact with carbon dioxide in the air surrounding it. If the cartridge you bought is packaged in simple shrink wrap and you had to dust it off when buying it, you are likely buying it from the wrong place. Ideally, the DI should be contained in a thick Mylar bag capable of preventing gas exchange. Even better would be a foil-lined Mylar bag. Better than that, vacuum packages as well. The only other thing I'd look for is to make sure you buy it from a vendor you know is moving through large volumes of media so you know it's fresh. Think of it like going out for sushi. I'm not eating there unless the place is busy and it is clear they have fresh product. Again, if the resin is sitting on a shelf covered in dust, look elsewhere. The number 1 and biggest cause of increased DI resin consumption is high levels of carbon dioxide in your water supply. The easiest way to know if your levels are too high is to use some of the calculators available online. The best solution for this is to fill your storage container with RO water first, then throw in a pump or air stone to let the excess CO2 gas off over a couple of days, and then use a dosing pump, slow gravity feed, or other solution to send the water through the resin. You should try to limit the flow through the resin to a few gallons an hour, similar to your RO system's flow rate, for best results. To be honest, this is kind of a pain. When most people do the math on the cost of setting this up and the space and time consumed, they would prefer to just buy more resin, possibly in larger, more cost-effective sizes. Check out the comments below. Tell us how long a resin cartridge lasts you and what you have done to increase performance. If this is your first time with us, we do this every week, so hit that subscribe button and give us a thumbs up. See you all next week on another episode of BRStv.